I'm going to show you how to quickly download assets from Reflect using a script that I developed with ChatGPT. And it will download things like images, PDFs as actual files instead of under a secure link like our exporters currently do. So I've put the script in here. So, you know, if you're used to running scripts, you can just use it right away. If you're semi-technical, here's a short instruction list. And if you're like me, who's not very technical, here is a more detailed step-by-step. And I, again, have done this with ChatGPT. And we're going to do it ourselves here. So the first thing we're going to do is I like to have just kind of a blank desktop here. And I'm going to open up the terminal. So if you've never opened a terminal before, it's just an application on your computer. And it lets you navigate your entire computer. That was a really bad description. If you're a developer, don't get mad at me. But that's basically what it is. So you can do everything from navigate files, change files, all that good stuff. So that's the first thing we're going to do. And we're going to just follow our instructions here. So you're initially going to need to make sure that you have downloaded or exported your Reflect files. So if I just pull up a new Finder window here and go to download, you can see that here I have the zip file of my Reflect download. And then, you know, if I click it, it'll end up into this folder here. So I've already got that downloaded. And then we can kind of go back here and now we can start here. So we've already got terminal open. And then the first thing we're going to do, basically each of these code blocks are things that we're going to copy and paste into the terminal or the script later on. But these are all the terminal. So this first one, I just paste it in here like that, push enter. It asks for my password here. And I am typing it, even though you can't see it and I can't see it. So don't get freaked out by that. Once you push enter, it will see the password and be like, I'm going to install this stuff. Is that okay? I'll push enter and it will install it again. And then I'm basically going to let that run and keep going through and doing the same thing for all of these. And you're just going to look that it runs normally and there's not any errors or anything like that. If you do encounter errors, you can go into ChatGPT and be like, hey, I'm running this script. I got this error. What should I do? But a lot of these will tell you what you should see because a lot of them are just checking for version numbers. So I'm going to fast forward to this part, but I'll kind of crank through these and come back when we are installing the request library. Okay, cool. I ran those. No errors. I didn't run these, by the way, because I did have pip installed. So that was the last one, pip 3. You can see it gave me a version number here. If I would have seen something that says error not found, then I would have to go do these two ones and then I could resume. But we're now ready to install the request library. So first, what we're going to need to do is set up a virtual environment. I'm not going to explain what that is. I don't really understand myself. That's okay, though. We've got AI. So I'm going to come over here and I'm just going to, again, keep pasting these. So this one, just make sure that I'm in my downloads folder. So you can see that now that's where this is navigating from. So anything I'm interacting with now is going to pull from my downloads folder. And then I'm going to create this virtual environment using Python here. So let's do that. And then you probably saw this in the background. I now have this, virtual environment env folder. So that means that worked. And then we're going to actually activate that environment. And now you can see we're not only in the downloads folder, but we're actually working in this virtual environment. So that's kind of cool. And now we can install the pip request. By the way, that's the reason, if you're wondering, you have to have the virtual environment. It might be a permission issue. I ran into this before when I wasn't using a virtual environment. ChatGPT was like, use a virtual one. And it worked. So I don't ask questions. Okay. So that's good. We've basically now got that whole environment set up and it's ready to go. And we can now start using the script. So this is the whole script. We're just going to double click on this code block and we're going to copy it. And now we're going to need a text editor. So I'm just going to use Max. I think it's their native text editor, just called TextEdit. I guess I'd probably recommend you doing the same thing. I mean, if you're not technical, you probably don't have one installed yet. So you might as well just use this one. And I'm going to create a new document and it's going to pull up this very, very boring looking text editor. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to paste that script in there and then I'm going to go back to our instructions because I want to keep following these and we're going to save the script. Now, your text editor might be in rich text mode. So if you see all of these editing options up top, that means it's rich text. Just go to format, convert it to plain text. And then we are going to go to, oh, sorry, one more thing you might have to do. Go into text edit settings, and then you're going to go over to the open and save tab, and you're going to uncheck this box. You don't want that box checked. Uncheck it, because we don't want a .txt file. So then I'll close out of that. And now we can go back in here, grab this file name, because this is what we're going to save the file as. And I'm going to go text edit, or excuse me, file rename, and then I'm going to paste that in there as a .py file. I'm going to push enter. Beautiful. That's what we wanted to see. You can expand this, and if this says .txt, that's not what you want. That means it's a .txt file. You want it ending in .py. So if it looks like that, very bad. This is not what you want. You want this. And then we're also going to make sure it saves to the downloads, because remember, we want everything in download. So I moved that folder there, and now you can see it's living in our downloads folder. Wonderful. But if we go back here, we now need to go replace these variables. So if I look in the script here, it just has these vague paths. It just says path to your unzipped folder. Well, that's not actually where these folders lived. We're going to have to actually replace these. And this is probably the hardest part, because you just have to understand the path of where your files live. And that's why I recommend doing it under the downloads folder. So as long as you've done that, then we can, I'm just going to copy this because it's kind of easier. I don't know. I probably should have just put this in the script to, you know, in the first place. But so users, that's going to stay the same. Your username, I'm going to replace that with my username. Download, it's going to stay in downloads. And then the path to your unzipped folder. So this, we need to get the Reflect files that it's going to be scraping. So I'm going to copy that. Make sure you get the zip file, not the unzipped folder there. And we're just going to paste that in there. Great. And then I'm going to just steal this part so I don't have to keep going back and forth. And I'm going to put that in there. And then, you know, this, I mean, you can give these folders whatever name you want. So I could just say like temp folder there. And then I'm going to do the same thing with this one. We want the same path. But I don't want it called zip file. I want it called, I'll call it reflect file. Okay. And that should be the variables, but I really want to highlight what's happening here, because I think this isn't a really easy part to go awry if you're not used to doing this. So you always want users. Everyone's going to have that. Everyone's going to put in their own unique username for their Mac, not your Reflect username. This is your Mac username. And then you're going to go to downloads folder, assuming you followed my instructions and put everything into the downloads folder, which by now you should have the ENV file, you should have the extracted file, you should have your Reflect exported notes. You can ignore everything else there. And then this first one, it's the file name for whatever your Reflect notes are called. So as long as you didn't rename it, you can just copy and paste this. I mean, I guess even if you did rename it, just copy what you renamed it. And then for the second two, you can choose the folder name. So I'm just putting temp folder. And this last one is, again, that's, you can choose what the output is going to be there. So I hope that makes sense for that part. I'm now going to command save that file so that we're good to go. And now we should be ready to run it. So what we're going to do is we're going to take this, even though actually I should be a bit more professional here. So I don't have to paste that in because I can see that I'm already in the downloads folder. If this only said, you know, Samuel R. Clausen, whatever, just this highlighted part, I would know that one, we're not in the virtual environment, and two, I'm not in the downloads folder. I can skip both of these steps because I can see that I'm already here. But if you want to do them again, it's not going to hurt anything. Okay, so now we need to actually run the script. So we're already, I just did this step number three. We're already in the proper place. Now I can just copy this, and this is the big aha moment. I'll paste it in there. Let's see if it works. Okay, that's a great sign. So you can see the temp folder was added here in my downloads, and now it's just running. And I am running this on my whole graph, so it might take, I don't know, like a minute or something. So I'll just kind of let it run. We'll wait till it stops, but it looks like it's succeeding because I'm seeing all the images and that stuff happen. So we'll just let her go. Okay, so it finished. I know it finished because I'm landing back on this. I don't know what you call this, like the starting carrot? I have no idea. But anyway, so now we have supposedly what's finished here. And if I click on this, I can see all of my files in here. Cool. And these are from all of my notes and stuff. So all of that good stuff. You see some PNGs, some GIFs. So yep, that appeared like it worked. And you could change this folder name to whatever you want. And then afterwards, you can go delete the virtual environment. You can delete the script if you want from your computer. It doesn't really matter. So I hope that all makes sense. It's really not that hard. I just wanted to kind of go through step by step. And again, if you encounter errors, like you'll probably, if you do encounter an error, it'll be in the terminal. I wonder if I can just trigger one. Yeah, okay. So like if you see something like this, it's like command not found. What you want to do is just like paste in the context. I mean, you could honestly just like paste in everything to ChatGPT and be like, here's the error I got, here's the script I'm running. You can even upload your script file and it should be able to tell you what to do next. So, yeah, I think that's it. Go enjoy downloading some assets.